Amen. Let's pray for the word of God. Heavenly Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus. As your word will fall on the fertile soil, I know that we'll be the doers, not the hearers. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. We thank God. We are here to study about the ministry of Jesus Christ, that is the priesthood ministry. When we are talking of the priesthood, we have already explained earlier on, and we'll go into detail so that you understand the ministry of Jesus Christ. Amen. So now let's open our Bible to Revelation chapter 1 verse 6. Revelation chapter 1 verse 6. The Bible said, and he has made us kings and priests unto God and his Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. That means Jesus Christ has made us king and priest to his dear God. So you and I, we have two titles, the king and the priest. Amen. In the old dispensation, as I said earlier on, there is the function of a priest and there's a function of a king. Now let's look at the priesthood ministry. This is what we are about to study. Let's turn our Bible to Exodus chapter 28, verse 1. Exodus chapter 28. Exodus chapter 28, verse 1. And I read, and take unto thee Aaron thy brother and his sons with him from among the children of Israel, that he may minister unto me in the priest's office. Even Aaron, Nab, Ahu, Isa, and Akama, son, Aaron's son. Amen. These are the children of Aaron and his family. So that means Aaron and his descendants are the ones who are meant to become the priest of God. They have been selected by God to become the priest. Let's open above the same Exodus chapter 19. Exodus chapter 19. Verse 3 to 6. Verse 3. And Moses went up to God, and the Lord called unto him out of the mountain, saying, thou hast said to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel, ye have seen what I did unto Egypt, and how I bare you on eagle wings, and bring you unto myself. Now therefore, if you obey my voice indeed and keep my covenant, then ye shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for all the earth is mine. And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests and an holy nation. These are the words which thou hast spoken, thou hast speak unto the children of Israel. God have already spoken what he has ordered Moses to do, to speak to the Israelites, that when they hearken to the voice of the word and obey the covenant, they will become a peculiar people to him. They become a kingdom of priests. It's the same thing when you accept Jesus as a Lord and personal Savior. You become a priest and a king together. This is a prophecy that has been fulfilled now. So now the kingdom of the priesthood, when you are talking of priesthood, priesthood simply means communicating to God. The word priesthood, that means talking to God. When I'm talking of talking to God, it's a property of a particular people within Israel, that is the tribe of Aaron and his family. Their inheritance or their property is to talk to God. And imagine, talking to God is a property for somebody. If you are not part of the family, you have not given the right to talk to God. So only those family are given the mandate to talk to God. And they talk to God one-on-one. From there, they relay the message to the people. So talking to God is their inheritance only. So imagine taking God as your property, talking to God as your inheritance. They distributed all the property. They didn't get some. But what they had was God as their property. That means communicating to God is their property. Amen. So imagine communicating to God is your property. What else do you need again? He created the heavens and the earth. That he said, when you want to communicate with me, only these particular people, the tribe of Aaron, Anyone who is not within, when you come there, God will consume you because you are violated. Amen. But Jesus came in the New Testament. Zechariah being the high priest, his son being John the Baptist, applied water and anointing came from heaven. So Jesus and John the Baptist transferred the priesthood unto Jesus. So Jesus went to preach and heal ministry. But the reason for Jesus coming, Jesus came as a king in order to destroy the work of the darkness. He didn't come as a priest, because if he came as a priest, he wouldn't get the right to touch every unclean spirit, because God have given direction that a priest must be clean. He should not touch something which is unclean. So John the Baptist being powerful, but couldn't heal the sick. But Jesus Christ is the one who can enter where the sickness is, because they are classified as unclean. So Jesus went there, break the rules, work, break demon, cast them out, fight the battle. So priesthood means communicating to God. Then kingship responding means destroying the work of the darkness. So when you are a priest, that means you are talking to God. Then when you are a king, that means you are destroying the work of darkness. So Jesus came to destroy the work of the enemy, but not to communicate to God. But as he's coming to die on the cross, he began to teach us how to pray. Imagine, none of his followers or his disciples prayed. Why? Because they were not given the mandate to do that, because they don't have the right to talk to God. But after the death of Jesus Christ, all of us now have been given the chance to talk to God. So now talking to God means priesthood ministry. Destroying the work of the darkness is the kingdom business. So the priesthood ministry means you are talking to God. So talking to God, you don't talk to God because you are sick. You talk to God because it is part of your duty that you have to discharge. It's a duty that you and I must discharge. Talking to God in any means, either through prayer, through singing, through worship, any means that you take to communicate to God. Because priesthood ministry means talking to God. Then kingdom business means destroying the work of the darkness. So you could be talking to God at the same time, you have burden upon you, Satan have targeted you. It is normal. The only time you can be free from this bondage by acting as a king to destroy the work of the darkness. You pray to God, that is talking to God for direction. Then use your authority given to you as a king to destroy the work of the enemy. In Jesus' name. Father, thank you for making it possible for us. I know that you have been touched. Now, study the word. Pray to God as your priesthood ministry. But when it comes to the kingdom business, it is a command that you and I must issue to destroy the work of the darkness. In Jesus' name, shall we bow for a word of prayer? Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus with thanksgiving. Amen.